Hey guys, today for the review, we have the KAIWEETS HT208D. We received this multimeter from the KAIWEETS company to make a review. It's the KAIWEETS HT208D Inrush Clamp Meter. Let's start with the unboxing. It comes with a semi-hard carrying case. There is the clamp meter. There is a thermocouple for temperature reading. There are the probe leads. There are three AAA batteries. It comes with a manual. Remove the plastic film from the display. Remove the back cover to insert the three AAA batteries. If you press and hold this button on the right side, the flashlight will turn on. The flashlight is at the top. This feature is especially useful in low-light environments. Remove the protective caps from the multimeter probe ends. Remove the protective caps from the multimeter probe leads. Most meters have two separate ports for the red probe, and you have to choose the right one based on the current you're measuring. Unlike many other multimeters, this one has just two ports, simple and straightforward. Insert the black probe to the COM port. Insert the red probe to the input port. To power on the meter, simply rotate the dial to the desired function. There's no separate power button. The first two functions measure current in both AC and DC modes. The first one can handle up to 1,000 amps. The second one can handle up to 600 amps. The next setting measures AC or DC voltage. The next setting measures frequency or duty cycle measurements. The next setting measures resistance. Press the function button to switch to continuity test. Press the function button again to switch to diode test. Press the function button again to switch to do capacitance measurement. If you press the function again, it goes back to resistance test. The next setting does temperature measurement. This setting is used to measure small AC or DC voltages in millivolts. The next setting does non-contact AC voltage detection. Let's put this clamp meter to the test. The first thing we'll do is check the current of this portable air filter. As seen in the specs, it requires an input of 120 volts and 0.56 amps. Turn the dial to the 600 amp setting. Press the function button to switch from DC to AC mode. Press the trigger and insert the power cable inside the clamp. There shouldn't be any amps showing yet. I'm turning on the air filter. The reading shows around 0.4 amps at low speed when I have the air filter on. At medium speed, the current increases to around 0.5 amps. At high speed, the current increases to around 0.7 amps. The next test is to check the voltage of this AA battery. Turn the dial to the voltage setting. This is a new battery, so it should have around 1.5 volts. The link to this clamp meter is in the description. The reading shows around 1.6 volts, which is a good sign. The next test is to do the AC voltage measurement. Press the function button to switch from DC to AC mode. I'm going to insert the probe leads into the receptacles. The reading shows 120 volts and 60 hertz. The next test is to do the frequency or duty cycle measurement. The frequency can also be measured in the voltage setting. Turn the dial to the Hertz setting. Insert the probe leads into the outlet. The reading shows 60 Hertz. The duty cycle is at 50%. The next test is to do the resistance test. Turn the dial to the resistance setting. This is a 220 ohms resistor. When I touch the probe leads to the resistor, the reading shows around 218 ohms, which is close to the expected value. The next test is to test this red alligator clip for continuity. Press the function button to switch to the continuity mode. I know this alligator clip is good, so I should hear a beep. I hear a beep, so there is continuity. The alarm indicator has a green light, another sign of continuity. The next test is to do the diode test. Press the function button to switch to the diode mode. The reading shows around 0.6, so this is a good diode. The meter returns the value very quickly. The next step is to perform a capacitance test. This capacitor has a capacitance of 10 microfarads. Press the function button to switch to the capacitance setting. When I touch the probe leads to the capacitor, the reading shows around 10 microfarads. The meter takes a few seconds before it shows the reading. The next test is to do the temperature measurement. The meter comes with the K-type thermocouple. Insert the black probe into the COM port. Insert the red probe into the input port. Turn the dial to the temperature setting. The temperature currently shows around 18 degrees Celsius and 64 degrees Fahrenheit. I've set my hot air rework station to 300 degrees Celsius. When I aim the hot air gun at the measurement junction, the temperature reading on the display increases. The temperature reading reaches a peak of around 310 degrees Celsius and 590 degrees Fahrenheit. The next step is to do the non-contact AC voltage detection. Turn the dial to the NCV setting. I have turned on my portable air filter. The tip of the meter is the NCV probe. When I point the NCV probe to the power cable, the meter starts beeping. The display shows the letter L, and the buzzer indicates a weak electric field signal. The alarm indicator also shows a green light. The display shows the letter H and the red light to indicate a high electric field signal. The beeping is also quicker now. This is a great clamp meter. The meter feels sturdy in my hand. It's packed with functionality. It has an easy-to-read display. It has good accuracy. It's a great value. Want to grab this meter? Check out the link in the description. And don't forget to use the discount code below to get 10% off. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.